I think it is very important to stress that no agrarian reform beneficiaries or no farmers who have been cultivating their lands be ejected. They must remain on the lands they till. We had to analyze the proposed budgets. I think that's why in assuming my appointment as the new DAR Secretary, I have to know and how I have to find out, and I would like to get the answers why in the last 4 years, from 2011 to 2014, I think the Congress allocated as a total available appropriation for DAR in 4 years, a total of 80.9 billion pesos. And out of that 80.9 billion pesos, 31 billion pesos are unused appropriations, and there is a breakdown of which 23 billion pesos are considered unreleased appropriations, and 8 billion pesos are considered released but unobligated. So I am interested to know the answers.
One of the most discussed issues in agrarian reform is Hacienda Lucita. What is the latest update and how do you plan to address the problems here?
That's one of the first thing that I have to do, to know now the status of implementation of the decisions and resolution of the Supreme Court with regards to the 4,115 hacktares of Hacienda Lucita lands, and also the process, the modes, and the status of implementation of distribution of these 4,115 hectares to the original farm worker beneficiaries. And then to know about part of the decision resolution of the Supreme Court regards to the 1.3 billion pesos proceeds of the sale of the 580.5 hectares. Why this amount has not yet been distributed to the poor original farm worker beneficiaries. And there's a pending petition for education filed by the AMBALA, the Alliance of Farm Workers in Hacienda Lucita, with regards to the conversion order issued by the DAR in 1996. So we have to act on that pending petition for education.
There are a lot of laws covering agrarian reform. What is your assessment of these laws, and do you plan to revise or update any of it?
There are inherent flaws, inherent loopholes embedded in the provision. So we have to have a national policy or the necessary act of Congress to legislate a new law for genuine agrarian reform with pre-land distribution of the central goal in order to address this issue. Because in the existing agrarian reform laws, if you are a partner beneficiary but you were not able to pay an aggregate of 3 annual amortizations, the mortgage of the land in the land market of the Philippines will be foreclosed. There will be a foreclosure proceeding. So, and that will mean the lands awarded to beneficiaries will be redistributed to another qualified agrarian reform beneficiaries.
You're really pushing for the distribution of lands, but you also have programs to make sure that these lands are in good condition when you distribute it to farmers.
Yes, it is enough that the distribution of the physical distribution plan, it has to be coupled with a comprehensive, holistic support services programs, to address the agricultural credit of the farmers, or a credit subsidy to for the agrarian reform beneficiaries to have a production capital in the face of this increasing production cost. And the farmer beneficiaries have to also seeds, farm inputs, farm implements, machineries, and another means of production. They should avail a fair and just prices for their farm produce, in order to increase their farm net income.